Finally got a camera for video. Oh, cool. Is it a crop sensor? What do you mean? You mean like full frame, micro four thirds, APS-C?
It's a Canon.
Yeah, it matters. So let's find out why. Hey guys, Camber here, back home in Mississippi, and today we're talking about camera sensors, and more specifically how the size of the sensor will affect your footage. And if you're new here, this channel is all about teaching you how to use your camera to make good videos, so if that's you, consider subscribing. So how does video work, and what role does your camera sensor play in the process? Well, light travels through your lens into your sensor, and through a process that we'll just refer to as magic, your sensor takes that light, converts it to a digital format, and saves it to your memory card, and there you have your video. And there are a lot of different sizes of these camera sensors, so we're just gonna cover a few of the more common ones and three of the effects that it's gonna have on your video. Now, the largest sensor you'll find in DSLRs and mirrorless cameras is the full frame sensor, also known as 35mm. But why 35mm? Because before the digital sensor magical process was around, there was a different magical process in which 35mm film was used in cameras, and so the light went through and was magically recorded to that film as opposed to the sensor inside the camera. Now, most camera lenses are made based on this 35mm full frame format, and since I'm using a full frame camera, the 35mm lens that I'm using right now makes the picture look like it's shot on a 35mm lens. The next popular size that we're going to cover is the APS-C size sensor, and this sensor is smaller than the full frame and it's used in a lot of less expensive DSLRs and mirrorless cameras. And this sensor has a 1.5 crop factor on your lens, and then after that there's the micro four thirds, which has a 2x crop factor on your lens. Now, what does this crop factor actually mean? So think of the camera lens, which is giving a circular picture, and then you have the square sensor, which is looking at a portion of that circular picture. Now, we'll assume that this square section is a full frame camera sensor. So then when we take a smaller sensor, such as the APS-C, you're looking at a smaller square of that same picture. And then when you get into the micro four thirds, you're looking at an even smaller portion of that same picture. So because you're looking at smaller and smaller portions of the same circular image, it looks like that image is zoomed in. So right now, my 35mm lens on this full frame camera looks like 35mm. But then if we switch, now you're looking at what a 35mm would look like on an APS-C size sensor, which makes the 35mm lens now look like a 52.5mm lens, because it's times 1.5. Now, Canon does a little bit differently. Their APS-C size sensor gives a 1.6x crop factor. So now my 35mm looks like a 56mm lens. Now, if we move on to the micro four thirds sensor, such as cameras like the GH5 have, now you're looking at a 2x crop factor. So the 35mm lens now looks like a 70mm lens. So you can see with the same lenses, it's gonna look a lot more zoomed in. And this is getting a little too close, so let's move back to the full frame camera with the 35mm lens looking like a 35mm lens. So even though it looks like the focal length is changing, the focal length doesn't change because focal length is a measurement from a point inside your camera to your camera sensor. So what you're actually seeing is a change in what's called equivalent focal length. And that's because the smaller sensors are seeing that smaller portion of the larger circle. Now, aside from that obvious change that different size sensors are gonna have on your camera lens, there's also low light performance to consider. A full frame sensor is gonna have better low light performance than a smaller sensor. And video is all about your sensor capturing that light. And so the more light you get, the less noise your picture is gonna have. For example, these two shots, you can see it's obvious that the full frame sensor has way better low light performance than the APS-C size sensor. There's way less noise in it, it looks a lot clearer. And you might be thinking, wow, I need to get a full frame camera so that I can have better low light performance. However, let's take a second look at that. Yes, the full frame camera does look better. There's nowhere near as much noise in it. However, neither picture really looks good, and I wouldn't want to use this footage. Now, video is all about capturing light, so let's throw a light into that same scene and see how it changes the picture. Now, both cameras look similar. Yes, there's still more noise in the shadows of the APS-C sensor, but the footage is fine and definitely usable for a video. So now we can take it a step further and change the placement of that light and work on shaping that light to give a more interesting look. And now we have that more cinematic look with some shadows added to the face to improve the picture even more, and both cameras are performing just fine. So just because the full frame camera has better low light performance, that doesn't mean that your shots will look good in low light. Now, aside from the changes in equivalent focal length and low light performance that different size sensors will have on your camera, there's also depth of field or the blurriness of your background to consider. A full frame sensor is going to produce a blurrier background than a smaller size sensor would. As you can see here, this full frame and APS-C camera are both set with the same shutter speed, ISO, aperture, equivalent focal length of around 50 millimeters. And you can see that the full frame camera definitely has a blurrier background than the APS-C camera does. So if you want the blurriest background you can get, that is something to consider. However, I really doubt anyone watching your video would really think,
that background's not very blurry. Should've used a full frame. That's probably micro 4/3.
So there's three main things to consider when it comes to your sensor size. One is the change in equivalent focal length and how various lenses will look on your camera. Two is low light performance, which isn't a big deal once you know how to use light properly. And three is the change in depth of field and knowing that you can't get as blurry of a background if you're not using a full frame sensor. But overall, knowing the limitations of your camera and learning how to work around those limitations is what's gonna turn you into a better filmmaker and make your footage look even better. So if you made it this far, go ahead and hit that thumbs up. Leave a comment down below about what kind of camera you use and what kind of sensor and crop factor that it gives. Go ahead and subscribe if you haven't, and remember that the only way to get better at something is to practice. So get out there and film something. See you soon.